Welcome, friends, to our Old Time Carol Sing for 2020 from St. Paul's Anglican Church here in Uxbridge. Normally, we'd be gathered together in the church and sing these wonderful carols together, but obviously because of COVID-19, we can't. But that doesn't mean we can't still sing. I want to thank Stuart and Tiina for joining me in preparing this video and in offering you these wonderful Christmas carols to sing, as we indeed do celebrate, even in the midst of a pandemic. I'll begin with a prayer. And this particular prayer that I will pray is giving thanks to God for the gift of music. So let's pray. Touch us, O God, through the ministry of music, and especially as we sing our Christmas carols that are so dear to us and tell the story of your birth. Through the sounds and the senses of song, through the wonder that fills our souls with heaven, through the spirit which teases our feet to dance and causes our hearts to overflow, may we be absorbed in the mystery of music. And in this moment, may we be one bonded to each other and bonded to you. Come, let us sing to the Lord a joyful song. Amen. The first one we're going to sing is, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Come all ye faithful,
wonderful, beautiful carol that indeed sets the tone for our whole celebrations of Christmas. As we faithfully sing out that joy, come let us adore him. And indeed we do. Our next carol is another favorite, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Virgin Mary had a baby boy, and they say that he's
Our next carol is, well, Shepherds Watched Their Flocks, and it's a beautiful carol because it really does tell the whole story of the shepherds and the angels and their visit to Jesus. Well, Shepherds Watched Their Flocks.
Lord,
Next carol is that beautiful carol, What Child Is This?
What child is this who laid to
Our next carol is a rousing rendition of Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Selected verses from the first Noel.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for joining us for this old-time carol sing. Stuart, Tiina, and I do hope that you have enjoyed singing along with us today. These carols are a treasure, and it's important that we sing them because they remind us of what this season is all about. That there is light even in the midst of darkness, hope in the midst of despair, comfort in the midst of confusion, even in the midst of a pandemic. A couple of things over the next week and a bit from St. Paul's. There will be our worship service for the fourth Sunday of Advent. That weekend, there will be an online lessons and carols service that will go on to our YouTube channel. On the 21st, the longest night of the year, there will be a longest night service on our YouTube channel. And then, of course, two services Christmas Eve, 4 o'clock and 7 o'clock, unless, of course, Durham Region is in the gray zone and we are locked down. Even then, though, there will be a video. If you are planning to come to the worship services, please do register in advance. That's helpful to us to know who will be coming. And now we close our time together today with a prayer. Let us pray. As once you came in the hush of darkness, O God, so still our hearts now by the wonder of this holy season. Make us wise with the wisdom of a little one, that truth might be born afresh in us. Let not our hearts be busy inns with no room, but doors opened wide to welcome a holy guest, a guest who is Jesus Christ, alive with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So friends, be well, be safe, be healthy throughout this Christmas season. And may God's blessing be upon each of you, your families, your loved ones, your friends, your neighbors, our community of Uxbridge, our parish church of St. Paul's, this Holy Christmas season and always. We're going to close with one final carol, a favorite to many people, and maybe it's your favorite too, Silent Night. We usually end our worship services by singing it together by candlelight. I invite you to join in singing Silent Night, and I invite you to offer it as a prayer. Let's pray together. Silent Night, Holy Night, all is calm, all is bright.